That's the funniest piece of test equipment I know. It sounds so good.
Hi, I'm Heimbach. It's good to have you back. I'm standing again next to my wall of test equipment because I want to go into a modular system that I really love but only mentioned briefly in a past video. And that is the Nuclear Instrumentation Modular, also called NIM-BIN. This is a modular designed for nuclear research, but you can find fantastic modules for sound in this. I've talked briefly about lock-in amplifiers in this format, like this PAR 2020, but now I want to go into something that's a bit more confusing and people often wondering, what can I do with this? And that's a boxcar averager, of which I've got 1, 2, 3 here, and I got another one over there, and I love them because what they do is they sing. Now, what is a boxcar averager? It is a tool from nuclear physics from the 1950s. With a lock-in amplifier, you look at frequencies. With a boxcar averager, you look at timed events. It consists of a trigger signal and a trigger delay and the ability to change the width of the trigger signal. And usually you also have some kind of amplifier in here, which is this. And then there's a way to average your sample size over time. All this helps to get rid of background noise and just look at what those pesky atoms and photons and electrons do. That is all the science I can get into because I'm a musician and not a nuclear physicist. What I do know is that this is basically a pulse wave oscillator. But the boxcar averager in this configuration by SRS Stanford Research Systems is not just this module. It comes with many additional modules. And as far as I know, they're still building these beautiful racks. So what we have here right next to the boxcar averager module is a gate scanner. And this was the biggest surprise I had because this works in musical intervals. Change the intervals here. You can change the speed. And it can go forwards or backwards.
That's the funniest piece of test equipment I know. It sounds so good. Let's stop this. And since I've got 3 boxcar averagers, I can make them sing together. Now this might be a little off, but with a little tuning you can get them to play these kind of test equipment fugues where one is chasing the other. But that is not where the magic of this ends, because there are analog processor modules in here, which are probably the crown jewels of this whole setup. These take 2 signals and you can combine them in very interesting ways. Here are 2 pinged filters, the Princeton Applied Research 189. These are the filters of the ARP 2500 in test equipment form, but they predate the
ARP in that regard. One signal, we got the other. Both of them, A minus B. And now to the square. These analog processors do more than just overdrive the signals. They mesh them up in interesting ways. And since it's always two signals, you get always new kinds of ideas. I haven't even tried working with those with normal signals, but judging from what you can do with these two simple rhythmic elements, I think the possibilities are very interesting. The other two modules that belong to this Boxcar Averager are the huge power supply, which has a handy analog meter, a digital meter, and a bar graph meter, so you can do some measurements if you need to directly here, as well as a computer interface that I haven't tried yet, because I'll probably need an old MS-DOS for that. Oh, and I have one now. There's one more important use for the Boxcar Averager, but first let's hear it all together. The Boxcar Averager is great for rhythms, as Dennis Verschoor discovered. I think he was the first to do that. He uses the Princeton Applied Research 160. On the SRS, it's kind of different, because what I like to do is send the main clock as a signal in into one or two of these gated integrators, and then use the internal rate to modulate that. And that can result in some off-kilter rhythms that are already nice. But then I patch that signal to all the other things and process it through the analog processors. And that sounds a bit like this. And of course, you can send this signal then to filters and ping them. I hope this inspired you, if not to pick up a Boxcar Averager to just see what other things can be used for music and experiment, because there's often much more to be found than at first meets the eye when you start experimenting. If you're just interested in the beautiful noises that this makes, I've got a nice sound pack up on my Patreon, as well as many, many more, and the track that you heard. And yeah, thanks to everybody who supports what I do on Patreon. You're the reason I can keep on with this madness. Thank you all for watching and subscribing. This channel just hit 100,000 subscribers, and I'm so thankful for that. So yeah, have a beautiful day, and I'll see you in the next one. And any comments, yeah, please, in the questions. Oh my god, it's too hot. Bye bye.